Good evening. So we are going to go through lecture 12 about cloud computing concepts. So in this lecture, we are going to look about the security of the cloud. What are the challenges we face in the cloud security and software as a service, the model of cloud security. In that model, what are security issues and security management and governance, risk management and some assessments. So this is a very, very huge topic, but we'll try to summarize it. So when you look about the challenges, there are so many concerns with particularly with the cloud service providers, because we are keeping our files on someone else's server. So for example, in the cloud, you lose control over your asset. Here the term asset means your important files. Okay, so then thereby we need to have a good security and also the total physical control is also given to the service provider. So they are sharing the computer resource with other companies. So the server where you are keeping the files, same server is shared by other companies. So we have shared pool of enterprises that you don't have any knowledge, they are just selling it, renting it to others. And storage devices also provide by any cloud vendor may have some incompatible with another vendor services. So there are some issues also like that, incompatible issues and encryption issues with the data passing into the cloud. So how the encryption is, for which algorithm they are using, and all of those issues are there. And like if we have both ways communication message passing, we need the SSL control, secure socket layer control protocol. Okay, that we want to bind it to our tunneling of the client and servers. And data integrity, this is also an issue, that data is being identically maintained during the any operation. And also put simply, the data integrity is on assurance that the data is consistent and correct. And ensuring the integrity of the data really mean that it changes due to like some response to other authorities. And this sounds good, but you must remember that a common standard to ensure the data integrity. And then we have the cloud service challenges. Using the SaaS offerings in the cloud, we mean that there is much less need for the software development. For example, we need a web-based customer relationship management. Just for that, we need to have some customization, like feed it to our company. And of course, we have combination of web services that also cause some unwritten security vulnerabilities, means weak points, and mission critical processes in the cloud. The suppliers, they have to have a data log of real time, means we need to have a real time data monitoring of those mission critical processes. So the system administrators, they have to every day look after those mission critical processes. And cloud application also must undergo some constant features of add-in and the user management also for them. For example, like Microsoft, they have their own SDLC. They are actually now focusing more on the mission critical softwares. Okay, that they have 3 to 5 year period in which every day or substantially they are not changing AI substantially, but the cloud may require a change in the applications. So in short, these are the ones. So proof of failover technology component is required to have overlook on the cloud. Company can survive if it's a non-critical one, but if it's a mission critical one, then that will be a big disaster for the downtime. So core business practices provide competitive differentiation. Sensitive data is the domain of the enterprise, but on cloud computing provider, there's a stress. So there are so many challenges they faced. And of course, compliance standards with the audits or other security frameworks. There's a huge body of standards applied in the IT security and the IT governance. Those rules or so regulations, they have to. And SaaS makes the process of compliance more complicated, since it may be very, very difficult for a customer to discern where it's been. Rest decide whatever the network or SaaS controller or the cloud partner that we have. And government policies is also another headache for the cloud providers, that these policies need always bring changes, and some of those changes arise some security threats. Okay, so we have this offshoring of personal data. Offshore means in another country server we are just keeping the personal data. So in that country the laws and regulation may be different than others. And we have cloud security challenges, like cloud-based services will result in many mobile IT users also today, as in the business data and services without traversing the corporate network. And this will also increase the need for enterprises and other security controls. And placing the large amount of sensitive data in a globally accessible cloud leaves the organization open to large distributed threats. And virtualization efficiencies in the cloud require virtual machines from the multiple organizations to be co-located, and although these traditional data center security still applies in the cloud management, and the administrative access through the internet rather than it being controlled by maybe just say a restricted direct or restricted premises connection, that only from that area only he or she can access. Then we have the dynamic and fluid natures of virtual machines. This is also very much because nowadays so many hackers, the attackers, they are using the virtual machines created and sold on 1 hour basis for the clouds. So also security issue with that. Then localized local machine and physical servers use the same operating systems. Or web application maybe in the cloud environment, it also increase the threat of the attack or maybe the malware, I mean the software that exploit the vulnerabilities of the systems along with the virtual. And operating systems and application also do files on a shared physical infrastructure. That's also what we explained before. And enterprises also, they need to have a security compliance audit team to look after security, the standards have been met or not. And in the rush, the advantages of the benefit of cloud computing, but very little of which has been coming into cost because we have to invest in security also. So when it comes to the SaaS model, the technology analyst or consulting firm, the Gartner, they have listed these issues. First one, privileged user access. So inquire about who has specialized data, access to data, and about the hiring and management. Second, regulatory compliance. Make sure the vendor is willing to undergo external audits. And third, data locations. Does the provider allow for any control over the location of the data? And fourth, the data segregation. Make sure that encryption is available for all stages and that these encryption schemas were designed. And some other like recovery. Or investigative support, like does the vendor have the ability to investigate like those illegal activities that's happening in the cloud? And long-term visibility, what will happen of data if the company goes out of business? So when it comes to security management and the people who are involved in this security management, so most important thing is we need a security team, a group of people to look after security in the organization. They will take the ownership of the security, and this also should be aligned with the company's security governance. We need a security steering committee, a very top level people developed with an objective to support and give guidance to the IT security and business in terms of securities. Risk management, of course, we need effective risk management for the business process, the software's application, data stores. So a periodic risk assessment should be done. Okay, corrective measurements should be taken. Risk assessment, yeah, this is the study of the risk, what type of risk we have and who will take care of this. So in the project management module, we have got very, very in-depth in risk assessment. So security in the cloud, security architecture design, vulnerability assessment, looking for the weaknesses of the cloud, password assurance testing, how weak or strong your password is, data privacy, data governance, data security, software or application security, and virtual machine security. So in all of these angles, we need to maintain security in the cloud. So software security architectures, we need a security framework, we need process, we need some standard operation procedures, some technologies and people to manage that. On top, we need a security program reporting also. That's about the security architecture design. So this is some of the services that in the security architecture design we have. Authentication means check whether the claim person is the right person before we allow it. Authorization, giving access to the right person. Availability, keeping the software 24/7 up, live, running. Confidentiality, keep the sensitive data safe, confident. Integrity, make sure not everyone can edit anything. Accountability means somebody has to held accountable for security, and of course not the least, but privacy of the data. That so these design reviews architecture, we need some periodic reviews whether those have been effective or not. Vulnerability assessment, look after the weak points, security layers, security concepts that we have actually practiced. And vulnerability assessment defines the network asset to more efficiency. Like previous week we heard in Maldives, there are so many emails being leaked because they are using the old password for many years. So there are some brute force software algorithms that they guess the password, some bots. So vulnerability assessment is also that we can identify how many days, how many years that you are using the same password. So best way is in every 21 weeks to change the password. Password assurance testing, this is also very important in terms of security, that we have to have, like, is it a weak password or strong password, or are you using your name in your password? So some kind of regulation we have to put there. Data privacy, a risk assessment and gap analysis on the controls and procedures that we are going to implement in the data. Define on this data, we have the formal privacy process and initiatives. And as with the security, the privacy controls and protection must an element of the software architecture design, and depending on the size of the organization and the scale of operations. So a member of the security team, those are the people who are responsible for privacy of all the corporate security components, make sure those security things are happening in place. And as with security, a privacy steering committee also should be created. They will make decisions like what kind of door access system we have, what kind of camera system, data center we are going to use, all of those things. And we can hire a consultant also to help us. And as companies move away from service models, they do not store the customer data today with us. Okay, because of the privacy concern in the different regions, we have different service models today. And data governance, some of the data governance frameworks, we have data inventory and data classification, data analysis for business intelligence purpose, actual sales or other data we are having the intelligence, data protection, data privacy, and data retention, recovery, discovery, and data destruction. Data security, the ultimate challenge in cloud computing is the data level security and sensitive data in the domain of the enterprise. And the security will need to move on the data level so that the enterprise can be sure that their data is protected wherever it goes. And also, if for example with the data security levels, the enterprise can specify that this data is not being allowed to go outside of like Singapore others. So application security is one of the critical success factors for a world-class or SaaS company, and this is where the security features and requirements are defined and application security test results have been reviewed. And this also should come up with the collaborative effect between the product development team and security development team. Sprint testers, all the coders should work together. So SaaS providers throughout the web today, they are very much concerned about the Open Web Application Security Project, there are 15 guidelines to develop the safe and secure application. Of course, the VM security is virtual machines. Today, so many hackers, they are using the virtual machine to attack. So firewalls or intrusion detection or any other monitoring or log inspection can help us to identify the behavior of virtual machines. And by developing the traditional line of defense by the virtual machine itself, you can enable so many critical data applications to work with. And the approach of virtual machine security, which connects the machine back to the mothership, so like some advantages, the security software can be put into single software agent. And thank you.